Hi, this is Andre. I want to talk about some different approaches that I personally have found really useful as far as practicing and developing rhythm and rhythm in looping. Let me lay out a couple of disclaimers here. First of all, these are things that I personally have found really effective as I have practiced them. Your mileage may vary. You may try some of this stuff and find that it just doesn't work for you, and that's okay. The second disclaimer is that I recorded myself practicing. I did not record myself performing, I recorded myself practicing. And as I mentioned later in the video, one of my favorite sayings is, if everything that you're practicing sounds good, then you're not really practicing. And I was definitely practicing in the context of this video. I say that because I'm not trying to present anything that I played in this video as any kind of example for anybody to follow, and a lot of it does not sound good, and that's okay. You know, it's okay to not sound good when you're practicing. It's actually a good sign, and we talk a little bit about that during the video, and I will talk a little bit more about that afterwards in the epilogue. In the meantime, here are some things that I personally have found really helpful as far as developing my comfort and my familiarity with rhythm. Thank you. the things that's really important to me, both as a player myself and as a music teacher, is the idea that playing and practicing are not the same thing. Practicing is really about zeroing in on things that we're not good at and finding ways to address them so that we get better at them. I cannot think of a lot of situations where we can improve in something, especially something musical, without specifically confronting the stuff that we're not so good at. And this is one of the hardest things about practicing, you know? If we get to a point where there are things that we can play, it's a lot more fun to do the stuff that we sound good at. But playing and practicing are not the same thing. Playing is ideally when we internalize all that stuff and we forget about it and we just relax and try and let go and be in service of the music. Practicing is all of the exercise and physical calisthenics and mental preparation and all that stuff that goes into it beforehand. Sometimes I'll hear people talking about certain techniques or skills they tried to learn, and they will basically say something along the lines of, yeah, I tried that and I couldn't do it and it just wasn't for me. And then they gave up. And to me, that's the wrong way to look at this stuff. A lot of things in music are going to require a lot of time just to sound decent at. And the fact that you might sit down with it and not be able to do it initially doesn't mean you'll never be able to do it. It just means that it requires some time. And it also means that it requires a particular process. You know, for me, a lot of practicing is about how that time is being spent. To me, 5 minutes of really specific, very focused practicing that's zeroing in on a very particular issue is more valuable than an hour of just playing along and only hitting the problem spots when we happen to hit them and then just running away from the mistakes when we make them. It's a lot more fun to do that. It's more fun for me too. I'm not trying to hold myself up as any example of anything. But I have found that to really make progress and to really get better at stuff, we have to be willing to look at the stuff we're not doing well, and we have to be willing to find ways and try ways of getting better, and we have to sit with that for a while. Sometimes it's going to take a little while before we get better. Sometimes it will even take a little while before we can tell if it's really getting us on the right track or not. So again, nothing in this video is intended to be a gospel that everybody has to follow. I'm sure plenty of people watching this video can play everything that I played in the video a lot better than I played it in the video. That's fine. You know, the issue here and the point for me is that this is the stuff that I work on and that I've found valuable and helpful to work on and that I continue to work on. I think that these are good general exercises, but again, your mileage may vary. Some of this stuff may be extremely rudimentary for you. A lot of it, you may find that if you sit down and try it, you're not going to sound very good. And again, that's the idea. Not that we're supposed to walk on stage and perform and not sound good, but when we're in the practice room, we're not on stage. When we're in the practice room, if we make good music, that's a bonus, but it's not really the idea. The idea is to try and develop ourselves. So, with all that in mind, I hope everybody's doing well out there. I will talk to you guys very soon. Bye-bye.